Hello everyone, this is Professor Pavan Shonkar and I welcome you in a 43rd lecture of Machine Design and Drawing 2. And in today's lecture, we are starting a new topic of the last unit, that is a design of piston. And we'll deal this topic directly with the numerical. Now, actually, this numerical is very vast. Okay, so let us see. The design of cast iron piston for a single acting 4-stroke engine for following data. So here, we need to design piston made up of cast iron for single acting 4-stroke engine. Okay. Some data is given here. Cylinder bore, that is a diameter, is given as 100 mm. Stroke is 125 mm. Maximum gas pressure is 5 Newton per mm square. Then indicated mean effective pressure is 0.75 Newton per mm square. Then mechanical efficiency is 80% and fuel consumption, that is the mass of fuel, is 0.15 kg per brake power per hour. Actually, fuel consumption, that is the mass of fuel, is given in kg per hour. Okay, so it is to be converted in a kg per second. Then a higher calorific value of fuel, either petrol or diesel, whatever. So it is 42 into 10 raised to 3. Actually, it is a raised to 3. Kilojoule per kg and speed is 2000 rpm. Any other data required for the design may be assumed. Okay, so lot much data is to be assumed here while designing the piston. Okay, so let us start with the given things. So data: cylinder bore, that is a diameter, is given. Diameter of cylinder is 100 mm. Then stroke is nothing but the length of cylinder or depth of the cylinder is 125 mm. Stroke is a length along which piston reciprocates. So this is the maximum travel of the piston in the cylinder, so that is known as a stroke. And maximum gas pressure is given as 5 Newton per mm square. Gas, we can say, is 5 Newton per mm square. Indicated mean effective pressure, so that is given by PM, is 0.75 Newton per mm square. Then mechanical efficiency is given, so eta M, mechanical efficiency, is 80%, so we can write 0.80. And fuel consumption, that is mass, is 0.15 kg per brake power per hour. And we'll convert this mass in kg per second later on while solving, okay, wherever we need it. Higher calorific value of fuel, so higher calorific value HCV is 42 into 10 raised to 3 kilojoule per kg. Okay, and speed, that is capital N, is 2000 rpm. Okay, so these are the given things. Let us start it for solving. So number one, now when we design a piston, we need to design like a piston head or crown, that is a top face of the closed end of the piston. Okay, so suppose this is a piston and there are some slots for the pressure rings, piston rings, then oil ring, two pressure rings are there. Third one is the oil ring. Then here, suppose connecting is connected. Okay, so this portion is known as a crown. Then this length is known as piston skirt. Okay, a barrel, piston barrel is there. Actually, barrel is what? the sleeve in which piston is reciprocating, we call it as a cylinder. Okay, so that is known as a barrel. This is a first ring, then second ring, then oil ring. Okay, so this complete circumference is known as a skirt, and this is known as a crown. And these thicknesses, right from piston crown to the first ring, then first ring to the second ring, these are the different thicknesses. So these thicknesses is to be determined in designing the piston. So we'll see one by one, step by step. So number one is piston head or crown. We'll starting with piston head or crown. Okay, so for piston head or crown, thickness of piston head, thickness of piston head on the basis of what? Strength. On the basis of strength. So standard equation from the data book is thickness of piston head as under root 3 P into D square by 16 sigma T. Okay, so let us put all the values. The values, those are not given in this numerical, we have to consider it according to the piston material, which is a cast iron. Okay, so standard values for the material cast iron, specifically for the piston, are given. So we need to select it. So 3, pressure is 5 newton per mm square. P stands for P, gas, that is a pressure of gas, which is given, and diameter is 100 square by 16. Now sigma t is I think it is not given, so it is to be 38. It is to be selected from the data book. Okay, so thickness comes out 15.7 mm. So standard value is 16 mm to be selected from data book. Okay, so ye ho gaya thickness. Now don't rely on a single answer, that is jaise humne thickness nikal li hai on the basis of strength, isko hume cross check karna hai. So how we could check it? So for four stroke engine, small n is what? Capital N by 2. So RPM kitna hai? 2000. So 2000 by 2. So ye ho gaya 1000. Okay. Now cross section area of cylinder kya rahega? Simply circle rahega. So it is pi by 4 D square. So pi by 4 into 100 square. So ye aayega 7855 mm square. Okay, 7855 mm square. Now here we are using a equation of indicated power, IP. Indicated power is PM into L into A into small n by 60. In previous numerical we use same equation, you might remember. So and what is PM? It is a mean effective pressure, mean effective indicated pressure. Length, that is nothing but the stroke, then area, that is L into D, and small n we have just calculated, 2000 by 2, that is 1000 and 60. So utilize all the values. Mean effective pressure is 0.75 into length is 125, so 0.125 in meter. Okay, because indicated power will calculate in a watt, so all the values which are in mm should be converted into meter. Then area, so area we have just calculated 7855. So 7855, this value is in a mm square, we need to use it in a meter square. So for mm, 10^-3, and for mm square, 10^-6. Now this value is in a meter square, got it? Into small n, that is 1000, divide by 60, got it? So this calculation gives answer 1227. What we have calculated, indicated power, so it is in 12270, sorry, okay, 12270 watt. I hope you are getting. Indicated power is PM into L into A into N. We put all the values here, and specifically here 785, that is area, is converted into meter square. Okay, that's why extra term 10^-6 comes here. Now after indicated power, we will calculate brake power. So for brake power, that is BP, is what? Indicated power into mechanical efficiency. We have value of indicated power, तो value थी हमारे पास में 12.27, kilowatt. Okay, so 10^3, and mechanical efficiency is 80%, so 0.8. तो ये brake power कितना आना चाहिए? ये आना चाहिए 9.8 kilowatt. Okay, already अभी 10^3 अलग इसीलिए किया कि we could write in kilowatt. So brake power we have just calculated in kilowatt. तो brake power मिलने के बाद में हम निकालेंगे heat flowing through the piston head. I am strictly following the standard procedure of designing of piston from the data book. Okay, just need to follow it strictly. Now heat flowing through piston is given by piston head, because we are dealing with piston head design. So piston head, so heat H equal to it could be C into calorific value HCV into mass of fuel into brake power. ये formula है, तो सभी values put up करते हैं. So capital C for given condition is 0.05 into calorific value was given in numerical like 0.15, and it is in kg per hour. Okay, I am writing as it is. Then m, mass, sorry, it's my mistake, this is a mass given. HCV is calorific value, which was 42 into 10^3 kilojoule per kg. Brake power is 9.8 kilowatt. So whatever the answer heat, that will be again will come in kilo. Okay, otherwise we can write 9.8 into 10^3 and 42 into 10^3 into 10^3, because calorific value is given in 42 into 10^3 kilojoule per kg, and brake power we have calculated in 9.8 10^3 watt. Okay, so whatever the answer of heat, it will be in a kilo. So I am rewriting the equation 0.05 into 0.15 by 3600. Now it will be in a kg per second into 42 into 10 raised to 3 into 9.8. So now heat getting is 0.86 kilowatt, or we can write 0.86 into 10 raised to 3 watt, or simply H is 860 watt. Okay, is it okay now? The next portion is thickness of piston head on the basis of heat dissipation. We have calculated thickness that was 16, okay, and we are cross checking it on the other basis. First thickness was calculated on the basis of strength, and next we are attempting calculate the thickness on the basis of heat dissipation. So on the basis of heat dissipation, on the basis of heat dissipation, the thickness of piston head, thickness of piston head is, so TH equal to, equation is H by 12.56 into K in bracket TC minus TE. TC minus TE. So putting the values, heat is 860 divided by, this is our empirical equation for thickness of piston head on the basis of heat dissipation. So 12.56, K is the standard factor, and the value for current condition is 46.6 into, and this difference, that is TC minus TE, is given as 220. Okay, so thickness of piston head on the basis of heat dissipation is 0.0067 meter. It means in mm it is just 6.7 mm only, 6.7 mm only. We need to select higher value among these two. At first we have calculated it thickness as 16 mm, okay, and on the basis of heat dissipation it comes out only 6.7 mm. So selecting larger value among two, hence taking larger value, so TH is 16 mm final. So this much effort and this much procedure has been adapted to select final thickness of the piston head. Now the second portion is piston ring. Piston ring. Okay, let us go through it. First task in piston ring is radial thickness of the piston ring. Now radial thickness in piston ring is, and the equation is given as T1 equal to capital D under root 3 Pw by sigma t, where Pw is a working stress of gas pressure and sigma t is a stress for the material for piston ring. Okay, so and it is to be selected from standard data book. So D is 100. I'm putting value 3 as it is. PW is 0.035. I have selected this value from the table. Okay, and sigma D is 90 megapascal or Newton per mm square. So thickness comes out as 3.4 mm. Now actual thickness of piston ring. This task is actual thickness of piston ring. So for actual thickness, equation is T2 equal to 0.7 into T1 to T1. Are you getting? This is a range actually, actual thickness of piston ring. So it is expressed in range, and range is 0.7 into T1 to T1. So points, let us calculate it. 0.7 into T1 is 3.4 to 3.4. So range is 0.7 into 3.4 is 2.38 to 3.4. That means range for actual thickness of piston ring should be, or should be within 2.38 to 3.4 mm, not less than 2.38 and not more than, should not more than 3.4. Got it? Clear? Now the next part is minimum axial thickness. We have calculated maximum axial thickness, so let us go for minimum axial thickness again for piston ring. Piston ring, and equation is T2 equal to, actually we have defined the range here, actual thickness, and range is 2.38 to 3.4 mm. Now we are actually calculating actual thickness, and it should come in between 2.38 to 3.4. So calculating actual thickness, equation is T2 equal to capital D by 10 into NR, where NR stands for number of rings. So D is 100, and 10 into number of rings are 4 for 4 stroke single acting. So T2 is 2.5 mm. It means that here we have calculated actual thickness and answer is 2.5 mm, and yes, it is valid because it lie in range like 2.38 to 3.4. okay, so our calculation is safe. Now we can comment like T2 as actual thickness is in a specified range, so it is safe. Okay, now distance from top of the piston to the first ring, distance of top of piston to first ring, that is a pressure ring on the piston, pressure ring groove. You might seen there are three grooves, first ring, second ring, and oil ring, third one is the oil ring. So from crown level to the first ring groove, we are calculating distance. Okay, so distance from top of the piston to the first ring groove, and is given, it is also known as the width of top land. Okay, width of top land. B1 is thickness TH, 2 1.2 times thickness. So again, that width of top land is specified in range, and range is starting from thickness to the 1.2 times thickness of piston head. Okay, so let us calculate. B1 equal to thickness is 16 into 1.2. So range is 16 to 19.2 mm. So range for width of top land is 16 to 19.2 mm. Okay, and width of the other successive ring, that means the second ring, width of second successive ring given as B2 is 0.75 T2. So each and every width is given in a range. Okay, so width of second successive ring B2 is 0.75 into T2 to T2, I think, yes, to T2. So let us calculate the second range, or the width of second successive ring is 0.75 into T2 is 2.5. So B2 की range कितनी आ रही है? B2 की range आ रही है 1.875 to 2.5 mm. Okay, so these are the ranges of first ring width and second ring width. Okay, put up in a box so that we could find later on. Now next part, तो यहाँ पे हमारे B1 और B2 क्या है? B1 is 18 mm and B2 is 2.5 mm. Okay, now gap between free end of the ring G1, G2, these are to be found out. We'll continue same numerical in next lecture. Actually, this is a very vast numerical. Later on, again we need to calculate piston barrel, piston skirt, then piston pin, and we need to check it for maximum bending moment. Okay, so we'll continue same numerical in next lecture, remaining part. Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you.